10 days ago, Bo Cooper, a 26-year-old leukemia patient, consented to be part of Dr. Terry Fry's first-in-human trial. But Bo's leukemia has taken a dangerous turn, potentially jeopardizing his participation in the trial.
So you have new fever and you have new pain. I suspect it's all part of the leukemia progressing. What I'd like to do under the circumstances, you know, with the new fever, is I would like to admit you tonight.
Fever's gone last time I checked.
Yeah, but you did have a fever today. You had a real fever.
It's just every sleep I can have out of the hospital means I'll get more sleep. Can I go out tonight and come in the morning? I'm pretty good at monitoring myself.
He was not supposed to be admitted till tomorrow. He'd rather stay at the hotel tonight with his wife than stay in here. I understand that.
My concern, just tell you from my perspective, I'm trying to get you to the cell infusion next week in as good a condition as I possibly can. I would like to have the night under close observation.
Ugh.
You okay?
Pain.
We just kicked on all of a sudden?
Yeah.
Bo, listen, you need to come in. We need to get your pain under control.
Yeah.
We need to keep you on
this. We had it under control.
I know.
It's frustrating.
Yeah. All right, Bo. What's going on with my patients? What's going on with the trial? Permeates my thoughts all day long. I had the unfortunate opportunity of being on the other side of the fence a little bit when my wife was diagnosed with a rare cancer, and in spite of 3 years of pretty intensive treatment, including being enrolled on, you know, a number of clinical trials, she unfortunately lost her battle and died from cancer. Having been through what I've been through, I can't imagine not taking care of patients with cancer in a way that offers, you know, some hope, some possibilities for patients that really have none. Things evolve rapidly in these kinds of patients with rapidly progressive leukemia. None of us really know where he's gonna be from that perspective tomorrow or the next day. So we really gotta get going with the protocol. The clock is really ticking.
The patients that make their way to the NIH, that make their way to Building 10, have already been through everything that modern medicine has to offer. And they come to you looking for, quite frankly, they're looking for miracles. And all we have to offer them is our science.
Stephanie Goff, a surgical oncologist, is one of the leaders of the first-in-human trial Anita McAllister hopes to enroll in.
I'm gonna have you sign this. This is a release of medical information form. We'll sign a print. I will take care of it.
I have heard of this place referred to as the National Institute of Hope. They're curing people of melanoma. To know that I can have the hope for that for myself as well, it's very humbling.
Have you ever been a smoker?
No.
You with your spouse?
Yes.
Before meeting with Anita, Dr. Goff needs to determine how fast her melanoma is progressing.
Show me her scan.
This is the latest scan. This is the CT of the abdomen, and these are the lesions.
This soft tissue change here is the lesion in the right breast. This lesion here, is melanoma.
Anita's melanoma has formed deadly tumors, also known as lesions, all over her body.
Follow-up imaging showed that she had progression of disease in her liver, most notably.
This is a metastatic lesion of melanoma. This is another lesion. These are other small subtleties that are also lesions. She now has disease in multiple organs, including the liver, the lymph nodes. Metastatic cancer is when the disease has left where it started. For Anita, that was the skin, and it leaves that organ, travels either through the lymph system or through the blood, and lands in another spot. And when it gets there, it grows. Cancer is an ugly thing. It's a cell that has taken the very essence of being a living thing and distorted it into something ugly.
Ms. McAllister, do you have a seat right here in this chair? We're going to grab your vital signs.
All right, thank you.
Looking at her films from 3 months ago, she didn't have as much disease as she does now. How much disease will she have in 3 months? Hopefully we can impact that, but we've got to get her treated quickly. Unfortunately, the statistics for stage 4 melanoma are not that great. Without any further treatment at this point, she's probably looking at a life expectancy of less than a year.